If I make more than $29,000 a year, will I be paying more in taxes?
Yeah, but the rich still pay more.
Will I have to?
Yes.
What do you think? Let me ask you, what do you think is the single biggest problem with the current healthcare system in the United States? How do you think it should be fixed? We've talked about this a whole lot. And do you buy the bill of goods that the official Bernie Sanders campaign is selling? I know we have a lot of former Bernie supporters. Where do you line up? Single-payer healthcare, universal healthcare? Do you know the difference? Which one do you prefer? Okay, let's go to this video for some context as to what we'll be talking about. The campaign of Bernie Sanders, they released this video finally explaining how they will pay, or he will pay, for Medicare for all. Lots of problems, but Medicare for all, here's their explanation.
The truth is, we are already paying for our broken healthcare system.
Why are you so shocked by this?
Right now, we spend over $3 trillion a year on a crappy, broken system.
Price crappy? Wrong, bitch.
We pay about twice as much per person as our friends in Japan and Germany. And for what? To have over 30 million people uninsured and over 40 million who can't afford the insurance they have.
I think I want my money back.
Yeah, probably shouldn't have gone with a casino clip, but also we pay for better healthcare. That's the most important question. That's the most. That's the question that I think is most imperative here. So this is something that's important. The premise is people are uninsured. Repeated studies have shown us that sometimes, by the way, an increase in total number of uninsured people, it actually just has to do with people who make above average income opting to go uninsured, while the actual number of uninsured poor people goes up. Sorry, of insured poor people goes up. This is me. I just had a stroke. People who can afford it
need some of that healthcare.
Forego insurance. Yeah. People who are poor, actually more of them are signing up. So the numbers are a little bit more complicated than they make it seem, and that's just the most commonly cited number, by the way. I was one of them. I was one of those people when I was in my early 20s. It was stupid. Don't roll the dice like I did, but instead I decided to save more money. I didn't pay for healthcare, and then I got the AIDS. All right. Next clip. Let's see how they explain. This is their big justification, is that it will actually cost less. That's the crux of it.
We're already projected to spend more than $50 trillion over the next 10 years for a system only a big pharma executive could love. A lot of that money comes from the government, but the rest, it comes from you. This would change for the better by moving to a Medicare for All system that will actually save you and everyone else in America a whole lot of money.
Help me, I'm poor.
Don't take that from me. Take it from a conservative study backed by the Koch brothers.
Who are you, LeVar Burton? You don't have to take my word for it. Here's a six-year-old who's barely literate. It's in a book. Just take a look. Like, what? I'm watching your show, LeVar.
I know, right?
Way to offload it onto the migrant working class. So, as far as the claim here, by the way, there's a Koch-funded study that proved that this plan would reduce costs, which, of course, I don't agree with, but they say over 10 years. Washington Post fact-checked it like 2 years ago, gave it three Pinocchios. That's one more than two.
Yep.
I just wanted to show that I know how to do some math.
There you go.
That's important. Actually, four out of the five studies conducted have shown that there is a cost increase for Sanders' plan. Hmm. Also important to note, the author of that study himself said that it did not show Bernie Sanders' plan would reduce costs, and he kindly requested that Bernie stop saying that it would. He's like, my study, it didn't say that, so it just kindly... Yeah. Stop saying it said that. Yes. By the way, hit the notification bell. If you're subscribed, that doesn't mean a whole lot. Hit all notifications and do consider subscribing to Crowder Bits, another YouTube channel that hasn't been banned by the overlords yet. So they do get my lawyer.
Don't say it.
Yeah, we're flying under the radar here by broadcasting it merely to everyone. Then they go on to explain this system in depth. Let's roll it, and I want to freeze it for a second.
Okay.
Let me explain how.
Okay, pause. All right, tax the wealthy. We already do.
Right.
They pay a disproportionate amount of taxes. Eliminate paperwork. Oh, really? Is that so? You'll be effective at eliminating paperwork. Federal government. And then reduce drug costs. Well, they don't really explain how they're going to reduce drug costs, just that they'll tell people, I would like you to stop paying so much for drugs. No. Okay.
We tried.
Kindly vote Bernie for re-election.
No.
Well, I mean, you know, he's not... let's do the actuary tables. It's going to be whoever is VP. let's continue.
It's true, though.
I have no idea.
It's very true.
Yeah, I have every idea. He'll be dead. let's continue after that freeze frame.
First, let's talk taxes. I know.
More.
I know.
Taxes.
That's bad. But let's do it. What Republicans and the for-profit healthcare industry don't want you to understand is that we're not talking about new money. We're talking about money that's currently being taken right out of your pocket by drug and insurance companies.
No.
So let's call this money the corporation's tax you tax. For example, the cost of an employer health plan for a family of four is $28,000, over $12,000 of which is paid directly by the employee through premiums and out-of-pocket costs. In fact, if you include healthcare premiums, the United States is already one of the highest tax nations in the world. All that corporations tax you tax is why the healthcare industry reports over $100 billion in profits last year alone.
So much wrong with this, but wait, hold on a second. You mean that employees have to pay anything for their healthcare? But it seems like the employers, the evil monocled employers behind a bed of pharmaceuticals, are paying for healthcare for a majority of Americans. Yes. Under this definition, by the way, we'll get to the $100 billion in profits. That's a really misleading number. But under the definition of this corporation reaches in your pocket tax, any time you pay for goods or services, you're being taxed by corporations. They're talking about it being
weird.
Sure, taxes get passed on as costs to the consumer. Someone tell big grocery, big tech app creators, and KitchenAid. Everyone.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm an OXO man.
OXO, huh?
Cuisinart.
Great stuff. Jeez. Best egg slicer ever.
This is like Breville. Skimping. The warranty's not so generous, but that's why I have my Amex. So they're not a sponsor. They'll be pissed. So the sleight of hand that here occurs here. Do you see what they say? $100 billion for the healthcare industry in profits last year. Okay, this is important to note because this is the kind of, it's not just as false as the previous study that they cite with the man saying, stop citing me.
Exactly.
That's not what I meant. But this is pretty misleading. I don't want to say dishonest. Maybe they don't necessarily know better. But what possibly could be misleading when you are citing a statistic, $100 billion in profit for the entire healthcare industry? Can anyone think what it is? Why would it? It's not a company. It's just general profits from an entire industry. Okay, that's important to note. For scale, look at the food industry, $137 billion in
profits. Food is a human right.
The tech industry, the top three companies alone, $130 billion in profit.
Wow. That's crazy.
Now for scale, the biggest insurer, health insurer, United Health versus, let's compare a company to a company. And this is really important, by the way, because the healthcare industry as a whole is not what is spearheading innovation. It's not, these are not the people who are creating new products. It is companies within an industry competing against each other. Yeah. Just like Apple invented the iPhone. We don't say, if you look at the profits of the entire smartphone industry and attribute the profits of the iPhone, no.
Right.
Samsung would love to get in on that action, but your phones exploded.
Yeah. Over
so
and over.
We look at companies. The company, the individual company who wants to be profitable, they are going to create, I don't know, the cure for the polio vaccine. It's not everyone pulling their resources together saying, hey, I bet you if we all just came in together, we could have $100 billion in profits. No. Companies want to make their name. They want to make their money back.
Exactly.
We'll get into how they do that in a second, but just naming an industry is not an accurate measurement here. So let's compare apples to apples. Apple themselves made over $59 billion in annual profits versus United Health's evil monocled health insurance company, $14 billion.
Hmm.
That's what we might call statistically significant. And lest you think that it's absurd to say, well, they can do that with anything. Germany declared the internet a human right. By the way, there's now an argument to be made, and actually I think the government sort of in a backhanded way has recognized this, that people can't work today without smartphones. And so now you can remember the Obama phone lady? Obama got us a phone!
That's right, baby.
I said, what do you have? I love that. What do you think about Mitt Romney? Mitt Romney sucks! I feel that way about Mitt Romney now.
Sucks.
That Obama phone lady was an oracle.
Prophetic indeed. Yes.
Mitt Romney's a pussy! Correct.
Way ahead of her time.
You and your cricket phone. So, you just declare anything a right, well, then there you go. You can simply subsidize it. Let's start by subsidizing, I don't know, Apple, Coca-Cola. Let's look at any company who they have more significant profit margins than the healthcare industry. And by the way, the reason insurance is so expensive is because there's a lack of competition when you compare it to other industries. Not more. Single payer would not help with that. You want to look at industries where you have skyrocketing costs. Look at industries that are the most heavily regulated. You can look at healthcare, you can look at education, and you can look at, I don't know, healthcare, education, transportation. You thrilled with the airline? Lines, folks. Here's something that Bernie doesn't address in the video or the campaign officially. He speaks for Bernie. Who will actually be taxed under this proposal? Now, they claim in the video, that it would only be the super rich.
Right.
Okay? A little bit of cold water here. If you were to confiscate the wealth of all billionaires, not in the United States, in the entire world,
wow.
billionaires in the entire grit-eaten world, it wouldn't pay for 3 average years of Medicare for all.
Dang it.
And if we really wanted to fund Sanders' plan, it's estimated, again by economists, people who Bernie sometimes cites, and they say, stop doing that! Stop! Don't do that anymore!
You're lying.
Hey, stop hey, doing
stop.
It. Take. Stop doing it because you are misleading and I could hurt you.
And I'm an economist.
It's estimated that we need to double all personal, corporate, and triple, I think triple payroll taxes. I think we have it. Yeah, Washington Examiner and Bloomberg there.
Jeez.
By the way, what's a payroll tax, you might be asking? Well, I want to make sure that I read this just so you're clear. Because a lot of people, if you're an employee, not necessarily an employer, this might be somewhat foreign to you.
Right.
A payroll tax is a tax withheld from an employee's salary by an employer who remits it to the government on their behalf. The tax is based on wages, salaries, and tips paid to employees. Payroll taxes are deducted directly from the employee's earnings and paid directly to the Internal Revenue Service, the IRS. I go by the full name here because I want to be accurate. By the employer. Hold on a second. Mm-hmm. That sounds like an actual corporation passing payroll taxes down to you. Remember they were talking about this? It's the corporation reaching in your pocket?
Yeah.
Let me ask you that. A lot of you may not know. Hey, I actually have to pay payroll taxes on every last one of you, ungrateful shits. Would you rather have that money in your pocket? It's going to Uncle Sam.
I would love it.
Sorry, yeah, screw you. You have no choice.
Aww. Come on. Why not?
That's a few grand apiece. That'd be one hell of a baby crib there, Audio Wade. I know that you are with child, but...
Life's going to be tough, kid.
I'm sorry. I love you. I'm just saying. It's just, if you knew how much I have to pay just to have you, just to pay... you know what? Fine. Okay. That's cool. I'll pass the costs on to the employees. Enjoy. Thanks, Bernie. So who falls under this super rich with the Bernie plan? Right? Here's something. He let it slip.
Uh-oh.
If you haven't seen this clip, it's anyone making over $29,000 a year. See if you can spot it.
Is healthcare free? No, it is not. So what we do is exempt the first $29,000 of a person's income. You make less than $29,000, you pay nothing in taxes. Above that, in a progressive way, with the wealthiest people in this country paying the largest percentage.
Okay, hold on. I understood a lot of words there that you want me to hate rich people and you like progressiveness. I understand that, but if I make more than $29,000 a year, will I be paying more in taxes?
Yeah, but the rich still pay more.
Will I have to?
Yes.
Eventually,
you will, in fact, be screwed. Yes.
So just so you understand, he almost said 25,000 there. So he was so confident.
Yeah. They upped the number.
That was him cleaning up his misspeak.
Yeah. Yeah. 29!
29! Son of a bitch! This is important if you're on board with the idea that wealthy people should pay more just because they happen to employ people and you hate the millionaire, billionaire, or over 29,000-aire class. Where does the money that is taken from the triple payroll taxes and personal and corporate taxes, where does it go?
From a nurse's point of view, where is all the money going? Why is it so expensive?
It goes into CEO's salary. Sometimes it goes into magnificent atriums in hospitals while they're closing down other community hospitals.
Can you believe?
Can you? But I know some of you are wondering. Some of you are wondering. No, I can't. I cannot believe. I cannot believe that your source there, your reference, was a random nurse. Say, this is one of the biggest, most heated political topics of our generation. For some perspective, we go to fat activist nurse from WOOD9 of Grand Rapids, Muskegon, and Schenectady. What's your opinion? Atriums? I don't know.
Tri-cities.
I'm just here for the coffee and Oreos. Now, let's look at some of the actual numbers. Does the money go right now with private insurers? Does it go just to big atriums and CEO salaries? I mean, I don't know, maybe? She's just a nurse talking. I wasn't able to verify it. They have yet to ask the most important question here. Does all of this result in better care?
Oh.
Not even close. Listen, and this is one thing. You can go back to some of our previous videos. I think I'll link it in an end card here so you can see it. There are two studies that people use to try and claim that these other countries have better healthcare. There's the Commonwealth, where it studied, I think, 11 countries, and the United States was 11 on that list versus the UK, who was one. There was another one, the international study, that had us right below Slovenia and above Cuba. So, I mean, what's the scale here? They're almost entirely subjective polling data. That's what they consist of. So the United States objectively leads the world, not even close, in access to medical technology like MRIs. You're four times, by the way, as likely to die in a UK hospital than in the United States. Yeah. They have notoriously long wait times. You can go back to previous videos to look up the likelihood of you dying from cancers to terminal diseases, compare the United States versus the other countries. Objective parameters, objective litmus tests that you can use, not do you like your healthcare? Well, I guess it's kind of free, so I'll live in the crap hole that is Canada, exactly. And I'm from there. But a lot of money, by the way, the reason it's so expensive and it benefits the entire world is that a lot of this money is also reinvested into developing new drugs and medical technologies, which brings us to our next point that Bernie doesn't care about.
Americans pay more for prescription drugs than anywhere else in the world. Why? Big Pharma.
We're getting ripped off by the drug companies.
That was cool.
Many of these drugs were developed using government research and grants, yet are turned around and sold at sky-high prices to those who desperately need life-saving medication.
He's doing drugs.
We're going to stop this outrageous price gouging and cut the costs of prescription drugs for patients in hospitals by more than half.
How? Well, that's for the next video.
Yeah. Okay. At gunpoint.
Understood. So simply, by the way, price fixing doesn't work. It wouldn't help things, right. Okay? And this goes back again to the previous point that we made about the profits with the industry. A huge chunk of that money goes into medical research, specifically drugs. Something else, too, keep in mind that drug prices soared under Barack Obama and with the Affordable Care Act, commonly referred to as Obamacare. I refer to it as Affordable Care Act, just like I referred to it as the Internal Revenue Service. I use full
good
words.
Job. Very nice.
So formal. You're close to them. So,
I'm not going to be Chink Uyghuring this thing. I am going to make sure that I use all of the syllables.
Good job. And the links.
Though, again, leftists, they love to claim that the drug prices continue to rise. No, actually, if you take the price inflation into account, this is one of the most controversial statements in President Trump's State of the Union address because it was accurate, taking into account the price of inflation. We've seen historic reductions in drug prices under President Donald Trump. Okay? Doesn't mean that it's perfect yet, but you do see that happening. And fixing prices is something a lot of people understand when they talk about price gouging. They complain about price gouging. Okay, if you were to fix prices, let's say Hurricane Katrina. People complain about this. There's an emergency, so people are price gouging. What does that mean? A convenience store owner understands that there's scarcity, and so all of a sudden, batteries, I don't know how much it is for a pack of AA batteries. What is it, a few bucks? Depends if you go with double alkaline lithium. They keep going and going.
True.
And that bunny and Duracell. I don't know.
The ones that
I think
explode.
They're all the same. It's all big battery. I don't trust them. But the point is, store owner of the bodega says, well, now that's not $3. That's going to be $30. And people say, well, that's price gouging. Well, you know what happens if that person doesn't charge more in that instant? Someone walks in and goes, hey, I can't believe I have all these batteries that are only $3. Hoard. That's what happens. And then you have to create more regulation that says, well, actually, we're going to guarantee that the price does not go up regardless of scarcity, regardless of supply and demand. But we are now going to be limited to 2 per customer. And then you have someone send in all their family. And then they go, they now all of a sudden they're hoarding even more batteries. And then they start selling them on the street and you create a black market. Anytime you try to fix a bureaucratic problem with more bureaucracy, I don't want to say anytime, but most of the time, it doesn't work that well. So going back to the drugs that have reduced in cost after Donald Trump, why do drugs cost so much too? We've talked about medical research. Let me put a finer point on it. The average cost right now to develop a single new drug is $2.6 billion.
Oh, wow.
That sounds pretty bad.
That's a B.
Then take into account that the approval rate for drugs entering clinical development is less than 12%. So it requires the big, evil, monocled billionaires, they have to invest.
Wow. Yeah.
And there has to be some chance of recouping on their investment. Who would spend billions of dollars with a 12% chance of a drug being approved? By the way, the money that goes into research, that's the reason why the United States, you guessed it, leads the world in the creation of new drugs and medical research papers. It's not even close.
I like leading.
They talk about this in the video. Germany doesn't spend as much on healthcare. Really? Germany doesn't? Well, I'm guessing that it's for very much the same reason that Canada doesn't spend that much on the military. You're welcome. And I say that as a Canadian, okay? People say, are you Canadian? I was born in Detroit, raised in Montreal. It's not that hard to figure out. I could run for president, but I don't want to. All right, next clip.
You don't even want to know how much the United States wastes on processing paper.
Oh, will you tell us?
It adds up to hundreds of billions of dollars.
Oh, hundreds.
We're going to replace this Byzantine system of paperwork and billing with one single payer.
Oh.
Uncle Sam.
That is not where the money should go on paper pushing.
Estimates show Medicare for All could save more than $500 billion each and every year on administrative costs.
Okay, this is true. This is a very true claim. private insurance, with the insane regulations and government red tape that we've talked about, they have a lot of administrative expenses. Absolutely, that is true. But the estimates that the Sanders campaign, they use, they're completely inaccurate. Why? Because you'd be expanding Medicare to everyone. To compare administrative expenses for Medicare currently as it exists, right, it's only for 65 and older. Yeah. Patients who are over 65, they spend far more overall on healthcare, so the administrative costs will, of course, be a much smaller percentage. Also, something else that's important to note, the administrative spending can actually lower all kinds of other costs and spendings within a healthcare health insurance company. It's just like here, we have to spend a whole lot on updating the studio, making sure that the insulation is not flammable, making sure that we don't have rats chewing on the wires in the attic, making sure that we have equipment here that can cost many hundreds of thousands of dollars annually that doesn't go directly into the pockets of employees because it allows us to work more efficiently, more effectively, and employ more people in the long run. So to look at it through this, just this myopic, it makes me very sad, but also angry. I'm really angry because then I realize I'm sad when I think of how much a company has to spend in administrative costs, and then I'm angry when I realize that the proposed solution to less paperwork is the federal government? just consider the number of pages for government bills ever. The Affordable Care Act was was 10,000 pages, and according to Washington Post,
just one copy.
That's not too long, because frankly, this is to be expected in any large and complex governmental undertaking. Yeah, taking over a fifth of the American economy could be considered sizable. And by the way, while we're talking about big evil corporations, I understand the problem with transparency. I believe that the government should absolutely ensure that companies, corporations, don't lie to people. They don't lie what's on their, they don't lie on the label. They don't lie to people as far as their business practices. I'm supportive of transparency, just like I'm supportive of the military, because I believe that's a legitimate role of government.
Yes.
That falls under the purview of government to make sure that consumers are not being lied to when they make their decisions. While we're talking about transparency, hey, we signed a healthcare bill that took over a fifth of the economy that, admittedly, from Nancy Pelosi, they had to sign to know what was in it. Compare that to the liability that a company faces. The reason they have to pay so much on administrative costs is because they don't get to, I don't know, where am I covered? I don't know about your copay. I'm going to sign and see what happens. Let me put this insulin needle in your lower abdomen and hope for the best. They don't get to do it. For context, when people talk about big, evil, corrupt corporations, and I agree, there are some. Absolutely, of course. I'm not saying that all of them are angels, but why do leftists, why do progressives, why does Bernie assume that everyone in the government is inherently altruistic? For context, Bernie Sanders of Vermont, Senator Bernie Sanders of Burlington, Vermont, is less beholden to insider trading laws than Jeff Bezos. It doesn't apply here. And this is important to go back to. Bernie, he did a whole video on here about how he'd pay for a $34 trillion a decade plan without explaining any real way that he would come up with this money. That's because we know the answer. It would be taxing everyone. Sorry, only if you make over $29,000 a year. I know why that doesn't
rich
affect
people.
The struggling middle class. That's why Donald Trump's a prick. But everyone making over $29,000 a year in their household, they would have to be taxed at significantly higher rates. And here's, if we have to look at a comparison, because these numbers don't exist in a vacuum. Look at how things went under Barack Obama. Premiums went up, deductibles went up, drug prices went up, and with Donald Trump, he hasn't gotten a whole lot done. I will admit that, but at least we've seen prices go down when you account for inflation. Yeah. But I have to go back. Before we end this, we're talking about Canada. This bothers me so much. People talk about the world, and they talk about, oh, how much less they pay in healthcare. Really? Places like Iceland, Denmark, Sweden. You can because of the Allies. You can because we decided that we were fed up when a couple of guys decided to take out some boats.
Yeah.
Then we showed up and said, all right, I had to come back there.
Not this shit.
Canada is a great example. I had to deal with this being raised my entire life. Yeah. Canada going, we don't have to pay this much for our drugs. Yeah, you're welcome. You're not the ones creating the drugs and the medical technology from which the entire world benefits. You want to know how you can actually gauge that the United States benefits everybody in the world, unlike empires to have come before it? This idea that the United States is an evil empire. Okay, imagine any other empire ever in the history of mankind. Okay, take your pick. You want to go with the Greeks? You want to go with the Romans? You want to go with the Ottomans? Let's go with Rome. Picture Rome, only instead of a little place, what you're talking about in Rome,
Yeah, well.
Give Rome The landmass of the United States, okay, not to mention the military, the purchasing power, the GDP, and Rome, for some odd reason, has the second largest country as far as landmass to the north of it outside of China, but I think it's at least close, the lowest population per capita, some of the highest concentration of rich, vast, natural resources with no way to defend it, and Rome says, oh, you know what? We're gonna engage in free trade with them and let them benefit from our modern medical innovation. We're gonna give Canada plumbing. I don't know what kind of medicine they had, but I think they had plumbing, and that was pretty cool back then.
Yep.
So the point is, it's never happened before. Yeah, you guys don't have to pay for your military because we foot the bill. You can look at NATO. We did a video on that. But if you wanna brag about how low your healthcare costs are because your government decides to subsidize American medical innovation. Well, this is just my opinion. I think we should shut that tap off and see how you like it. And Canada, you know what? You're going to have to start buying some more tugboats and propeller planes because you no longer have the luxury of being protected by our Marines, by our Navy, and our Air Force.
Boom.
Also, we're not giving you any more penicillin. Piss off.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, subscribe or hit the notification bell because that lets your mobile device. Do people still say cell? I don't think they say, but no one says LTE. We used to say cellular, but we don't say LTE. But then, what was it? There was roaming. Do we still have roaming? I think we still have roaming. If you're watching this on mobile, I've wasted a ton of your, and you're likely driving. You're probably dead. You're probably just looking back now, and the road is just, there are some lights and sirens going off. Maybe there's like a pair of slacks in the grill of your car, next to the Rudolph nose that you put in for some holiday festivity, only now it's covered in someone else's blood. So hit the notification bell. Join Mug Club at liedwithcrowder.com/mugclub because that's how we support this. We don't actually make any money off of YouTube, and we do a full daily, like 80% more content. And you know what? I hope that your blood type is O negative.